Hi, welcome to Offerman Solutions. In our previous encounter, we looked at products of two functions. That's finding the relative of products of two functions. We realized that there are instances that we'll be given two functions and then we want to find the derivatives, what the functions are multiplying. And we employed Leibniz. Leibniz came out with a very nice theorem which helps us to find higher derivatives as far as product of two functions are concerned. I hope you've watched that video because we are going to base our argument on that particular theorem. So let's look at that. Just a quick reminder. The theorem says that if you have two functions, u of x and v of x, and these two functions are continuous. Okay, this one is continuous and this one is also what? Continuous. This one is n times differentiable. And this one is also n times differentiable. It means their product. So the product of these two functions are also n times differentiable. And that becomes the nth derivative, okay, of this product u of x, v of x, becomes the summation. Okay, so r beginning from 0 to n, n combination r. Then the r of the first function, so u of x, then the so the r of the so we have this, then the n minus r of the second function. So this is the theorem as far as Leibniz is concerned. We looked at one case in the previous video, so you need to go and watch it. Alright, but in this video, we just want to look at an example. So it will happen that, say, we should find, so we are looking at example one. So find the thousandth derivative. So you are differentiating to thousand. Okay, so of x, ln x. So you'll find the thousandth derivative of this. So when you look at this, if you don't take time, see you have to jump, then you have to. But you realize that with the help of Leibniz theorem, this is no problem. You can just quickly look at it. So you look at it, this product of functions, this is x, and this is ln x, and they are multiplying actually. So the only thing we need to do at this moment is to state that, okay, by Leibniz product of theorem as far as product of functions are concerned, the thousandth derivative of this x mean x will be equal to, so we pick it from here, summation y r begins from 0 to 1000, then 1000 population r. Then what is the first function? We have this one here, x. So we have this thing multiplying d. So the r of what x, then times the n minus r, and the n minus r. Then at this point, we need to remember something very interesting. We recall in the previous video that we're going to find the nth derivative of ln x. So ln x, we have ln x like this. Then the nth derivative of this particular function ln x is equal to what? Are you remember? So we're going to say that we'll have negative 1, n minus 1, then multiply by n minus 1 factorial. Then x into, so you have something like this. So if you are not comfortable with this, you need to check out the video concerning this and be comfortable. Because from today, we'll be using this one often. So we quickly put this here, we have negative 1 to the power negative n minus 1, multiplying n minus 1 factorial, then we have this, all this. So we have set up the problem, and in no time we'll finish. But let's go. it's about summation. So first, we start with R being 0. When R is 0, it means this will become 0. We have 1000 combinations 0. Alright, and what we come here, this place becomes 0. So if 0 derivative means you are not differentiating at all. So we have x there, no differentiation. Now if R is 0, it means that n is 1000, then if you subtract 0 from 1000, we still have 1000 there. It means that we are going to differentiate the x 1000 times. You see the importance of writing the m derivative here. So that if you are differentiating this 1000 times, the only thing you look for is where you can see n. Then you put 1000 there. So I can see n here, so I put 1000 here. And that gives me negative 1 to the power 999. See, that gives us negative. So you realize that you get negative. We put the same thing here, we have 999 factorial. So this gives us, so you have this one being multiplied by negative 1 from here. Then so n minus 1. Okay, so that n minus 1 factorial becomes 999 factorial. So 999 factorial. We have x to the power 1000. So we have finished the first one. We move to the next one. Remember, we are doing this 1000 times. So plus. So r now becomes 1. So moving from 0, we go to 1. So our r is 1. If r is 1, then this place will give us 1000 combination 1. Alright, so this place becomes 1. So it means first derivative of s. So if I differentiate s once, you see I'll get 1. So it's not even necessary to write here. Then I move here. Remember my r is 1. So if I subtract 1 from 1000, I'll get 999. It means I'm going to differentiate this side 999 times, which is so simple as just substituting 999 here. And when I do that, I mean this place got 998, which makes this place positive. Okay, so I come here and this place becomes 998 factorial. Then here I have 999. Let's continue. So now R becomes 2. So if R is 2, I need to come here and differentiate this one twice. Now you agree with me that after differentiating this one once, we differentiate s, we get 1. Now if I differentiate again, what I'll get to be 0. And that 0 will be used to multiply whatever we're going to get subsequently. So you see that from here, when we continue, everything we'll be getting will be 0, 0, 0, 0. So we have finished the differentiation of this particular product of functions 1000 times. The only thing left is for us to simplify a bit. So we come here. So this gives us 1. We have 1 here. Then this x here is to power 1. So when the bases are the same and we are multiplying, then we add the powers. So this gives us negative 999 factorial multiplied by x 999. Then plus, so this gives us what we have here. So this gives us 1000. We have 1000 here. Alright, so that 1000 is multiplying 998 factorial x 999. Let's see whether we have some common factors. Now look at it. This is factorial, this is also factorial. Now we've learned that if, for instance, we are looking for 5 factorial, then I can write it as 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. It is the same as writing 5 times 4 factorial. Why? Because 4 factorial also gives me 4 times 3 times 2 times 1, then times the 5, then it's the same thing. So using that idea, we come here and say that the 999 factorial here can be written as 999. So the negative is just multiplying everything here. So 999 times 998 factorial. Then x 999 then plus